Apple just released a brand new Thunderbolt 4 cable that costs a whopping $159. And if you're like half the people on the internet, you probably lost your mind when you heard the price. Now, Apple is known for charging their consumers a lot of money to get access to technology that might be readily available for at lower cost price points. I mean, really, who's gonna spend $159 on a cable that you could really go down to Amazon and buy for maybe a third of the cost, if most? Well, you are in the right place because in today's video, we're gonna talk about why this Thunderbolt 4 cable is not only a great value, I'm gonna give you 5 reasons why it's the best cable on the market and why most people should buy this if they are needing a Thunderbolt cable. Let's get started. What is going on, everybody? It is Mike. Welcome back to the channel. Glad that you are back with me today. Now, let's talk about this Thunderbolt 4 cable and let's level set on what this cable is. Now, this cable itself is available in 2 different lengths. There's a 1.8 meter version, which is $129, and there's a 3 meter version for $159, which is the version that I have here. Now, for those of you following along at home whose eyes glaze over when you hear metric versions, this is roughly 5.9 and 9.9 feet in length. Now, each of the reasons that I go through today are gonna be like filter criteria that I would use in order to figure out whether or not I should buy this cable. Because at $159, it is awfully expensive. But again, I will show you why it's not only the best deal out there, why people should buy it. Number 5, maximum compatibility. Since the cable is Thunderbolt 4 certified, it means it's backwards compatible with Thunderbolt 3, which means it can go ahead and support throughput as up to 40 gigabits per second in addition to USB 4. It is also USB 3.2 Gen 2 certified, which means it'll work with devices that are capable of delivering up to 10 gigabits per second throughput with this cable, giving you one cable to connect all of your devices. But in actuality, there are many different cables that you can buy that are gonna be lower cost than this $159 option. As I mentioned in the beginning, there is a shorter option, which is half the length, and it's $129. Apple's own Thunderbolt 3 cable is 0.8 meters and it's $39.99. So that's still considerably amount cheaper. But practically speaking, I wouldn't invest a whole lot of money in buying Thunderbolt 3 cables because I want my devices to be as compatible with future devices going forward, so I don't have to worry about buying cables at that point. But if you want to maintain maximum compatibility, you want to make sure that you have obviously the right cable and the right interface that you're plugging into. Thunderbolt 4 is the stricter version of the Thunderbolt 3 spec. It improves reliability, improves security, and it improves device capabilities. I always want to make sure you're using the newest version of the spec, assuming that that spec is backwards compatible. So at $159, the Apple Thunderbolt 4 Pro cable is not necessarily a good deal because, you know, there's a lot of cables that you can buy that are Thunderbolt 4 compliant and that offer the same backwards compatibility. So at this point, I would say, let's not buy it. Number 4, build quality. Apple's Thunderbolt 4 Pro cables are very high quality. This is the version that comes with the studio display. And you can see here that the cable itself, it's all black braided fabric. The jackets on here are, I would say, they're of normal length, but they seem to be good quality where you shouldn't necessarily get the, I'd say, the common issues where this jacket starts to fail and you lose connectivity. This cable itself is very thick, especially compared to other Thunderbolt cables. But since this cable is brand new, it's obviously very hard to test the manufacturing quality of the cable, but I don't think it's unreasonable to come to the conclusion that, generally speaking, Apple makes high quality cables and this cable should really be no differently. But if you don't want to subscribe to that idea, I would say that when you look at this cable, if you compare it against maybe cables from CalDigit, cables from Basis, cables from OWC, the cables seem to be in line with the manufacturing and the quality of those manufacturers. And those cables are, I would say, very high quality. Now, again, just because it has high quality doesn't mean that you should pay $159 for the cable. All the bells and whistles are not worth the $159 if you are evaluating purchasing this cable strictly on the quality of it. Now, in terms of connectivity, Thunderbolt and USB-C cables can either be active or passive depending on the length. Shorter cables are generally passive. They don't require any type of signal conditioning circuitry that is in the cable in order to boost the signal from one side, the sending side, to the receiving side. As the cable length increases, signal conditioning circuitry does boost the signal going from one side to the other to maintain maximum bandwidth. You know, physics and shit. As part of the updated Thunderbolt 4 spec, cables that are under 1 meter or roughly 3.3 feet don't require any type of signal conditioning, allowing manufacturers to produce lower cost cables that have the maximum bandwidth for that cable length and making them more generally available while still offering good performance. Now, that's a change from Thunderbolt 3, where the cables were limited to roughly 0.5 meters or 1.6 feet. This meant that Thunderbolt 3 cables longer than 1.6 feet were either high cost because the length dictated the fact that they needed the necessary signal conditioning circuitry to hit the maximum bandwidth, or the cable was lower priced at the expense of throughput, which was capped at 20 gigabits. Now, that's the exact problem that I have here. I have a dual 5K display, and the 5K display that I have on my far side or on my left-hand side is in vertical orientation. And when it's in vertical orientation, the cable length to reach my Mac is just longer than the cable that I need. So what I thought I could do is I would introduce a Thunderbolt 4 dock, the one from OWC that I've reviewed in the past, I'll leave a link up here, to help with that, but also I would connect one of my NVMe drives, non-volatile memory exchange, I think it's called, whatever, it doesn't matter. So when I introduce that, I actually get one of my devices, my monitor, that actually powers down because there's not enough bandwidth between the monitor itself and the NVMe drive to be sent over that backhaul. Introducing Thunderbolt 4 as the backhaul allows that cable length to be longer and for me to get maximum bandwidth with all those devices. Now, I probably could have gotten the shorter cable for less money from Apple for $129 versus $159, but the cost per inch, that's what I'm trying to equate to, would be much more. I think it's like $1.35 or $1.36 per inch when you think about 118 inches for this 9-foot cable versus it's roughly like $1.65 or $1.70. You can check my math down below and let me know when you think about the 2-meter cable. So if you're looking for, you know, what's the best cost per inch, this is the option for you. While Apple's cable is an astonishing 9.9 feet, it's not the longest cable out there. Corning introduced optical over Thunderbolt. No, Thunderbolt over optical. I think back in 2017, and these cables came to market last year, or actually the end of 2020. But the cables are cost prohibitive, I would say, from a consumer standpoint, with the lengths being from 5 meters all the way up to 50 meters, but the price starting at $350 and going way, way up from there. Even if it's not cost prohibitive, it's probably not the best choice in this type of scenario in a home where you have, one, it's not backwards compatible, two, it can't deliver power. So if you were trying to charge your laptop from the Thunderbolt cable, you couldn't do that. You would still need to connect your charger to it. And in addition to, there's no forwards compatibility. So because of the circuitry that is on the cable, which makes it really that expensive, it does need to have some type of limited protocol that it supports. And for these cables, it's only gonna be Thunderbolt 3. Now, there's really no word from Corning on whether or not these cables can be upgraded or if you have to buy new cables to support an initial protocol. But at this point, it's unknown. I would say at $359, it doesn't really matter because that cable is, you know, 2 times the price as this cable. So we've ruled out the fact that you shouldn't buy a Thunderbolt 4 cable if you're looking just to maintain or enhance compatibility, because there are many cheaper options that are available on Amazon, you know, from OWC, from CalDigit. And those cables, because they have the same compatibility as this cable itself, you should not buy this cable. And we also ruled out that just because it has tremendous build quality, other manufacturers are really on par with this build quality for the most part when you are buying a high quality Thunderbolt 4 cable. So that's not really a good reason to buy the Thunderbolt 4 Pro cable from Apple. And as we start narrowing down on cables of different lengths, optical cables, while they are very nice, and when we even abstract costs from the picture, they're not backwards compatible. They don't support USB 3.2. They don't support Thunderbolt 4. So they're very narrow in their specific application. And for me, I would rather have the ability to charge my MacBook Pro over Thunderbolt when connected to my studio display versus having an optical cable that I can have maybe at a great distance. But the picture starts getting a little more clear when we talk about data throughput and whether the cable should be active or passive. And it gets even further clear when we start talking about cables of varying lengths. Obviously, if you need a 5 meter or 10 meter or 20 meter cable, the only option that you have is going to be going optical. But for most people, these cable lengths of 9.9 feet, I would say, is a very good scenario. I can take this cable and run it from here to the other side of that door, and it's still gonna be long enough. So what is the number one reason that you should purchase the Thunderbolt 4 Pro cable from Apple for $159? First and foremost, like everything that Apple does, the sum of the parts is more important than the individual components.
An iPod. A phone. Are you getting it? These are not 3 separate devices.
And if you've been paying attention at home, I've listed out all the reasons why you should buy this. One, you get maximum backwards and forwards compatibility across a broad set of devices, including monitors, computers, and drives. Second, you have high build quality that is, I think, synonymous with Apple's products that they offer in general. Third, you have the design and engineering that go into making this cable. And quite frankly, there are no other manufacturers that are making a 9.9 foot Thunderbolt 4 cable that is active. There are none, literally. So fortunately enough, if you need a Thunderbolt 4 cable that is longer than 2 meters and you want high quality and you want the maximum amount of bandwidth, the cheapest option that you have is the Thunderbolt 4 Pro cable from Apple. Guys, that is gonna do it for me. If you like this type of content and you wanna see more like it, consider hitting like on the video, maybe even join the community where I do other types of breakdown videos like this. My studio display is coming next. Hopefully you'll be around for that. My name is Mike, and I will catch you in the next one.